Hi, I'm Father Kevin Anderson from Christ Our Light, here to tell you about our big parish event that is happening all day on Sunday, September 15th. It's our Parish Fall Fest. It begins at 10 o'clock in the morning with an outdoor mass, and then it's a full day of activities, live music, food. We have carnival stuff, bingo, a raffle going on. But we also have a silent auction. Bidding's gonna start on Wednesday, September 11th at 12 noon. It's all online. There's like over 100 items that you can choose from. But also, the whole Fall Fest is an opportunity for families to come together. This is open to everybody, not just parishioners, but all of you. Also, volunteer. We've got opportunities still for families or individuals to help out, whether it's at the beer garden or whether it's helping in the kitchen or doing one of the children's events. This is our huge, big event. We look forward to you joining us.
Good evening. Welcome to Christ Our Light Parish. My name is Kevin Sharp, and I am Director of Faith Formation here. Today, we hear the story of a miracle in which Jesus performs a healing in a very intimate way. He draws a deaf and mute man away from the crowd, puts his fingers in his ears, and having spat on them, touches his tongue as well. Jesus is right here in an intimate way with us as well. He's waiting to touch the places in our hearts and lives that needs God's healing grace. Please join in singing number 645 from the blue hymnal, Amazing Grace. Number 645.
His word, my hope. long as life endures.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Again,
welcome all of you. For you visitors and those watching at home, I am Father Kevin Anderson, pastor here. As you know, next weekend we are celebrating Fall Fest. It's exciting. So thinking of that, let's picture yourself at Fall Fest, okay? You got to make a choice. Would you rather be cheering on the Vikings in that garage area we have, or playing bingo? So, greet the people in front of you, behind you. You got to choose one of them and tell them why. You got to tell them why. Go ahead. Guess what? You can do both. You can do both. And lots of other things. So we hope you're going to join us next Sunday. We recognize that sometimes we have to make choices. Sometimes we have to decide this or that or do this. Sometimes we don't make the best choices. So as we continue, let's take a moment of maybe where you have goofed up lately. You said this, you shouldn't have. You did that, you shouldn't have. So we ask God's forgiveness. Jesus, you are our light. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Jesus, you are our truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Jesus, you are our salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
If you'd open your hymnals inside the front cover, there you'll find the Gloria. Together we pray. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and received adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our first reading. So here's the setting for the reading. It's about 600 years or so before Jesus is born. The Israelites, they're over in captivity, they're over in Babylon. Well, God is speaking to them through the prophet Isaiah. And God is saying that you will be going home back to Jerusalem someday. You will find that I will free you from this captivity. And when that happens, I'm going to transform the way, the land between where you are and Israel. I'm going to transform it into something lush. Here's what God says.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication, with divine recompense. He comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleansed. Then will the lame leap like a stag. Then the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert, and rivers in the steppe. The burning sands will become pools of thirsty ground, springs of water. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join us in singing our psalm refrain 93 in the blue hymnal. I will praise you, Lord. 93. While I live, it is the Lord who loves.
We continue to hear the letter from St. James. Now, this is unique because James is not writing to a special group of people, but to everybody, all Christians, to us. And James is notorious for really pounding in our heads to say it's not just worshiping or talking, but it's doing something. So here he's focusing on how we tend to judge others. That's what he says.
A reading from the letter of St. James. My brothers and sisters, show no partiality as you adhere to the faith in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ. For if a man with gold rings and fine clothes comes into your assembly, and a poor person in shabby clothes comes in, and you pay attention to the one wearing the fine clothes and say, "Sit here, please," while you say to the poor one, "Stand there or sit at my feet," have you not made distinctions among yourselves and become judges with evil designs? Listen, my beloved brothers and sisters. Did not God choose who are poor in the world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom that he promised to those who love him? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Again, Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee, into the district of Decapolis. And people brought to him a deaf man who had a speech impediment. They begged Jesus to lay his hands on him. Jesus took him off by himself away from the crowd. He put his finger into the man's ears and spitting touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and groaned and said to him, "Ephphatha," that is, "be opened." And immediately the man's ears were opened. His speech impediment was removed and he spoke plainly. Jesus ordered them not to tell anyone, but the more he ordered them not to, the more they proclaimed it. They were exceedingly astonished, and they said, "He has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." The Gospel of the Lord. Many years ago, when I was a young priest,
there was a concerned person who called me because there is a young man who I knew that all of a sudden he has this young woman move in with him. They were living together. So this concerned person said, you need to call them and straighten them out. You need to take care of this. And I'm like, oh, I don't know. No, you got to do this. You are the priest. You got to do this. Oh, I don't know. She just kept badgering me. Okay. So I called a young man up and I said, look, I know you got this woman living with you now. It's not right. You should not be living before you get married and going on. He said, priest, stop. You have no idea what you're talking about. We are not together. She's not my girlfriend. She's staying with me because I am protecting her from her abusive father. It's a bad situation in her home, and she's here safe from him. So back off, priest. Whew. I felt pretty stupid. Wow. I was doing what a lot of you do. Judging without knowing the facts. Here, I was trying to be helpful. I was trying to improve the situation. What I should have done is listen to what Jesus said to the deaf man in the gospel. He said, be opened. Now, that doesn't mean that I would change the way I think about living together before marriage. I'm never going to tell a couple, oh, goody for you. I'm so happy you're living together. No, I'm never going to do that. Never, never. But I got to be more open. I can't be so quick to think that I know all the facts or know what's going on. Like many of us, I got to start looking at things from different perspectives. For example, look in your worship sheets. Why don't you take those out in front of you? You see the two illustrations that are there? Look at number one. If you look at it from one view, you see one image. You look at it from another view, you see another image. Can you see that? Like there's a bald man with a big nose looking to the right. Can you see that? If you look the other way, there's a girl and we'd see the back of her head. Can you see both of those? Depends how you look at it. Okay, so look at the other one. Number two. You can probably see an image of a dog, right? Can you see the other image? Can you see the other image? Well, flip the sheet upside down. Now look at it. Ah, ha, 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 it's a sloth. See, sometimes you just have to look at things from a different perspective. Jesus is talking to us when he says, be opened. Not just our physical health, but sometimes we have to look at what's going on physically in a different way. For example, there's a man that I know who has cancer. And he said to me, this cancer is the best thing that ever happened to me. I'm like, what? What are you talking about? He goes, oh yeah. Because with this cancer, I have now improved my diet, what I eat. I have exercised more. And I don't take others for granted like I've always done. I'm more appreciative. He says, in a sense, this cancer has saved my life. Whoa. Be opened. Or, if you recall what we heard from the second reading, the words of St. James, where he's talking to them, but it could be us too. He says, we got to be open when we see somebody and we start judging, like by what they're wearing, and we already think we know everything about them. We think that, oh, because you're wearing this or you're wearing that, ugh. Think of how many times that you've seen a bumper sticker on a car, and right away you're going, oh yeah, okay, I know what they're thinking, I know what they're doing. Or you've seen a flag or a sign in someone's yard, and you right away are rolling your eyes going, oh yeah, okay. Well, no, no, we make assumptions, and you know when you assume what you make out of you and me, right? So kids, you can ask your parents about that later, okay. But instead of being furious about something we heard, become curious. So many times we are fed things like on social media, and they have us locked into a certain way of viewing the world because the algorithms. And so many times you think you're getting the truth, and you're not. You're just getting one side of the picture. But for all of us, we got to start looking at things differently. And when you get that article or that information on social media, you got to start being more curious. Is there another way of looking at this issue, another thing going on? For you kids out there and those watching at home, you've started school. And so many of you already are locked in saying, oh, I hate this class. Or, oh, I'm not going to like this teacher. You've only been there a couple days, and already you're thinking you are defining your whole year. Well, you got to start opening yourself up, just like Jesus said, be opened. Stop judging so much. Stop getting stuck and think, this is the way this year is going to be, or this is the way that teacher is going to be. Maybe for you kids, got to start thinking like, maybe I could do something different this year. Like maybe there's a club or organization you could join. You haven't ever done it before. Maybe there's a sport or activity. This is the year to be open, try something new. Or you kids, you know, remember that kid from last year that you didn't really like a lot? Well, maybe this is the year you are more opened and try to build a relationship, a friendship. As opposed to lock down and say, no, we're never going to be friends. I'm never going to like her. I'm never going to like him. No. To be opened. Or maybe there's a new kid in your school. Maybe you're the one to go introduce yourself or sit with him at lunch. Be opened, as Jesus says in the gospel. I think for all of us, that would apply, say, like to our Fall Fest coming up next weekend. That many times we get locked into saying, well, I'll just show up or I'll let somebody else do the work. No, Fall Fest is an opportunity not just to have fun, but an opportunity for you to get involved. And perhaps this is your chance. Sign up for something. We're going to have those sign-up sheets. We have them in the entryway and also online. Maybe it's trying something you've never tried before. It's a way of getting to know people. Maybe it's doing something like, oh, looking at those silent auction things and maybe having a bid there. Maybe it's showing up on the day and doing something different, whether it's bingo or the Vikings, something you usually wouldn't do, but be opened. Now, here's the best one. Be open to what God has in store for you. So many times when we pray, I do this, we get locked into saying, God, I need this, or God, I want this to turn out like this. So think of that thing you got going on right now in your life that you're struggling with, a huge thing or that just a little thing. Maybe your prayer could be, God, surprise me with this. As opposed to, I need this to happen, or it's got to turn out this way. Mm-mm. Let God's goodness be there to lead you in a different way of looking at it differently. Let God's grace surprise you. Pray for it. And then expect it. Huh. I wonder how you're going to surprise me with this, God. How you're going to handle this. Just like Isaiah was telling the Israelites in that first reading. God wants to help you. You just heard it where God says, be strong. Fear not. I have come to save you. Please stand. We know that saving action of God because of what we profess. If you'd open your hymnals, in the front cover you'll find the Nicene Creed. Let us profess together, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages,
God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Opening ourselves to be surprised by what God will do, we offer these following concerns.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that our ears may be open to those crying out in need, and that our lips may be open to express those needs to all who may help fulfill them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in authority, may they hear the cries of the poor and the oppressed and choose to respond to them with restorative justice and practical assistance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the victims of the recent school shooting in Georgia, for their grieving families, and for the entire community, may they be counseled by healing, by the healing power of Christ, and may we, the people, resolve to find ways to end the scourge of gun violence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On National Grandparents Day, we pray that all grandparents may know they are treasured by their children and grandchildren, have the ability to be a source of wisdom and joy, and know that they will be cared for as they age. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, may they receive the proper care to be restored to health and wholeness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have gone before us in death, especially Omar O'Connell, for whom this Mass is being offered, that all will one day be united in the joyous heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have gone before us in death, especially Wayne Stay, for whom this Mass is being, for the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, that they may be united with the prayers of Mary, the Queen of Heaven, and all the saints who live in light, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray also for those who have died recently. This includes parishioner Glenn Westman and Ed Stay. May God hold them and all the deceased in a loving, tender embrace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you hear our prayers. May we hear you. May we hear your voice that invites us to be opened every day. We say this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Our hymn for the preparation of gifts is in the blue hymnal,
Number 651, Open My Eyes. Number 651.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty. And by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart. We pray this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
If you'd open your hymnals to number 233, get ready to sing the Mass parts, number 233. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world, and you have arranged the changing of times and seasons, and formed us in your image, and setting humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever to praise you in your mighty works, through Christ. And so with all angels, we do praise you, and in joyful celebration, we now sing.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name.
Blessed be Jesus, whom you sent to be the friend of children and the poor. Jesus came to show us how we can love you, God, by loving one another. He came to take away sin, which keeps us from being friends, and hate, which makes us all unhappy. He promised to send the Holy Spirit to be with us always so that we can live as your children. God, we now ask you to send your Holy Spirit. Make these gifts of bread and wine into the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. The night before he died, Jesus, your Son, showed us how much you love us. When at supper with the disciples, he took bread, gave you thanks and praise, broke the bread, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice filled with wine. He thanked you, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again.
And so, loving God, we remember that Jesus died and rose again to save the world. He put himself into our hands to be the sacrifice we offer you. Lord our God, listen to our prayers. Send the Holy Spirit to all who share in this meal. May the Spirit bring us closer together in the family of the Church, with Francis our Pope, Patrick our Bishop, with all bishops and all who serve your people. Remember, God, our families and friends and all those we do not love as we could. Remember those who have died. Bring them home to you to be with you forever. Gather us together into your kingdom. There we shall be happy forever with the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and our Mother. There all the friends of Jesus the Lord will sing a song of joy.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Any kids out there that want to come around the table, please come on up. We invite all of you to join hands. Come on up. Join hands. Together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
I invite you to share a sign of peace with those around you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. If you wish to receive a gluten-free host, come in my line, which is over here. And if you're not receiving, you can always come up and just cross yourself and we'll give you a blessing.
Our communion hymn is On Our Worship Sheet, Lord, I Need You.
Thank you. Your sin runs deep, your grace is more. Grace is found, is where you are. And where you are, Lord, I am free. Holiness is Christ in me.
So teach my soul to rise to you when temptation comes my way. When I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. When I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you.
Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness.
For our prayer after communion, please look in your Voices as One songbook. Inside the front cover, you'll find the Ignite Faith campaign prayer. Together we say, Guiding Spirit, you inspired our forebears to build two communities of faith to serve your people. We thank you for all the blessings of the past and all the gifts that you continue to shower upon us in this, our present time and place. As we look to the future of Christ Star Light, we ask that you shape our hearts anew to be a generous people. May we be a faithful people, bringing your light and love to all, both now and for generations to come. Grant us the grace to remember that we are your holy temple being built together into a dwelling place for God. We pray this in your holy name. Amen. As I mentioned, we have a few funerals coming up. The funeral for Glenn Westman will be Tuesday, September 10th at 11 o'clock with an hour review beforehand. We'll still have our Tuesday night mass. And the funeral for Ed Stay will be on Friday the 13th, also at 11 o'clock, hour review beforehand. But there will be no morning mass that'll take the place. So please keep both families in your prayers. And as I mentioned in the homily, you have a chance to sign up to volunteer. We still have openings. So they're online, those watching at home, you can do that. We're also, and there's a big board in the entryway. There's also raffle tickets you can buy. Get those in, so we get yours, but you can buy more. And after all the masses this weekend, in the back of church, you get a sneak preview of all the silent auction items. Ooh, you can't bid yet. That starts Wednesday at noon, but go back there and check them out. There's some incredible things. It's just so fun. And then, of course, as we look forward to next weekend, just a reminder that on Sunday, the 15th, we'll only have one mass. That'll be at 10 o'clock, and it'll be outside. So bring a blanket or a lawn chair, and certainly bring your joy for that day. We celebrate. This weekend, we're celebrating Grandparents' Day. So if you're a grandparent, why don't you stand up? Wow, let's give all those grandparents a hand. Thank you. Congratulations. Nice. Okay, you can be seated, grandparents. If you are celebrating a birthday today or this coming week, please stand. If you have an anniversary of any kind today or this coming week, please stand. If you're involved in a school sport or an activity, please stand. As a participant or a coach or an official, we pray for your safety. If you're going to be traveling soon and would like prayers, please stand. If you have family or friends overseas in the military, full-time as missionaries, please stand. And if you are grateful for God's blessing in your life, please stand. The Lord be with you. May God bless you all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This celebration is ended. Let us go. Love God.
Our closing hymn is also on your worship sheet, Onward to the Kingdom.
Sing we now and on we go, God above and God below, arm in love we go, onward to the kingdom. Star above to show the way, through the night and into day, with the light we won't delay, onward to the kingdom. Sing we now and on we go, God above and God below, arm in up we go, onward to the kingdom. Come, sisters, brothers, to be the word of God, with another standing call, onward to the kingdom. Sing we now and on we go, God above and God below, arm in love we go, onward to the kingdom. In the promised land we'll be, one with God where all are free, deaf will hear, the blind will see, when we reach the kingdom. Sing we now and on we go, God above and God below, arm in love we go, onward to the kingdom.